Hi, my name is Kate. I'm a physical therapist, and today let's talk about foot deformities in children. Some of them can already be noticed in the neonatal unit. Some of them require no treatment. Some of them, unfortunately, do. Among others, I would like to tell you a few words about calcaneovalgus foot, metatarsus adductus, pediatric flatfoot, and of course about the clubfoot. And after that, I will tell you how I, as a physical therapist, can help in the treatment of children's feet, and I will tell you a few words about the method that I use. Let's start with a brief overview of some of the major foot deformities in children. But please remember, this is not all. These are just the most popular ones. And remember that in practice, we rarely come across the deformities which are simple and obvious, such as those from the books. Usually, we are dealing with mixed defects that contain different components. Calcaneovalgus foot. The calcaneovalgus foot is one of the most common defects in the neonatal period, and is characterized by positioning of the foot in dorsiflexion and the heel in the valgus position. Plantar flexion is limited. In extreme cases like this one, the dorsal surface of foot can rest on the anterior tibia. Although it looks threatening, this defect has a very favorable prognosis. Usually the condition resolves spontaneously in 3 to 6 months. Passive stretching and possible casting is used if necessary. Metatarsus adductus. In metatarsus adductus, the forefoot is adducted and the lateral border of the foot is curved instead of being straight. Metatarsus adductus often occurs on both feet. In this deformity, the hip is also affected. It is positioned in adduction, which intensifies the internal rotation of the thighs. In therapy, we use passive stretchings. Pediatric flatfoot. Pediatric flatfoot, called pes planovalgus, is a collective term for defects characterized by abduction and pronation of a child's foot. Both of these elements may be present in deformations like congenital flatfoot, otherwise known as talus verticalis, pes valgus, pes abductus. Flatfoot can also be spastic or can appear in fibular aplasia. Therapy, depending on the severity, includes stretching the contracted muscles, exercises, mobilization techniques, and if necessary, surgical treatment. Clubfoot. Clubfoot is a congenital deformity of the foot, otherwise known as a congenital talipes equinovarus. It is manifesting with four main deformities: midfoot cavus, forefoot adductus, heel hindfoot varus, hindfoot equinus. In clubfoot, the gold treatment standard is a Ponseti technique, which involves serial casting of the foot and bracing. Casting usually starts in the first week or two following the birth. They are changed every few days and usually there are 5 to 9 casts required. So usually every week the cast is removed and the foot is stretched farther toward the correct position and then it is recasted. Bracing is the second phase of treatment which maintains the correction achieved. Ponseti protocol recommends abduction bracing with boot and bar and this should be implemented immediately after the final cast. The patient should wear the brace 24 hours per day for the next few weeks. Sometimes during the therapy, if dorsiflexion is too small, then percutaneous Achilles tenotomy is indicated. This therapy is very hard, both for the baby and for the parents, because it is a long-lasting therapy and both the cast on the leg and later the brace make it very difficult for the child to move spontaneously. However, we as physical therapists can support the child's foot with appropriate stretching techniques, helping tissues to restore their elasticity. And now the most interesting part, what a physiotherapist can do about foot deformities in children. The method that I use is a three-dimensional manual foot therapy by Mrs. Barbara Zukunft-Huber. She's a German physiotherapist who closely monitored the development of children and she based her method on neurophysiological basics. She has written several books, including this one. I got a Polish version, but it's also in German. The title of the book in German is Der kleine Fuß ganz groß. And this book describes individual deformities. You will find here also case studies. And you will find here stretching techniques, exercises techniques. And by the way, no one is paying me to advertise this book because on my channel you will never find a paid promotion. I just really think this is a well-written, very good book. Okay, so what is a three-dimensional method? As the name suggests, we focus here on all three dimensions of the foot, its length, width, and height. First of all, this method gives us therapists very good diagnostic tools. These are appropriate grips and tests on basis of which we are able to assess the correct development of the lower limb and detect possible deficits. When we find deficits, we use therapeutic techniques, mainly stretchings. The last element of the therapy is a functional taping or wrapping with a special elastic bandage wrap. We tape in a certain way and in a certain direction. The physical therapist shows the parents how to do these exercises and taping, and then parents continue doing it at home because the therapy has to be done every day. This therapy is effective for many foot deformities, of course not for all of them, as some of them require surgery. But it is for sure a method that allows for effective stretching of contracted muscles, normalizing tension, supports correct gait patterns, and above all, is non-invasive and does not limit the child's development in any way. That will be all. Please write in the comments, do you know this method? I'm very curious how in your country these deformities are treated, whether in your country physiotherapists are involved in the treatment of foot deformities in children. Please share your experiences. Thanks for watching and see you next time.